What is going on, guys? Evolution here. Today we're going to be checking out a brand new Battlefield 5 weapon, the Ribe Rollies 1918. It's a brand new assault rifle, fully automatic, with a fire rate of 540 and a magazine capacity of 25. So my first impressions on this weapon are it's mediocre. It's not very good. It needs something. Something needs to change with this weapon. Because I found it very inconsistent when trying to take down enemies, and I would get beaten out at almost all ranges while using this weapon. And I'll explain more about what I mean there after we get through the specializations. So, as you guys can see, I've gone for the entire right-hand side of the specializations tree, and that is because I like to aim down sights quickly, I like to have that bullet speed, and being able to move with increased accuracy is really helpful for how I play. But you could also go for the left hand side with that faster reload, which I think is very good on this weapon, and that hip fire. So if you do get into trouble in those close quarter engagements, you can hip fire. The option is there. All right, so now I would normally talk about kind of each range individually, close, medium, and long, with the weapon and how I feel it can handle those situations. But honestly, we're just gonna kind of go through the entire list here at once. So in close range, I feel like I'm getting beat by every SMG, which, you know, it makes sense. This is an assault weapon. You're not going to be going toe-to-toe with all of the SMGs. That's fair, you know, fair enough. But I feel like I was almost getting beat out by SMGs at medium range with this weapon. I just didn't feel like the DPS was there because of that fire rate. I would land 3 to 4 bullets and then I'd be dead. It would just be nothing left of me. If I didn't land a headshot, I did not get the kill. Or if I missed a couple of bullets, again, I'm dead. So you have to really, really hit your shots with this weapon. Otherwise, you will struggle. Even going against other assault rifles and carbines, semi-automatic rifles at medium range, I would still kind of feel inconsistent with this weapon. I would land a headshot and then a couple body shots and then I wouldn't get the kill. I do like 80 to 90 damage, and it just, there's something about it that feels off. I definitely think it needs a little bit of a damage buff, or it needs a little bit of a fire rate increase to maybe just give it that little bit to make it feel more in line with the other assault rifles. And then even at long range, well bipodded with a 3x, I really had a hard time kind of tap firing, trying to take out snipers and stuff, because the recoil on this thing is quite intense at those long ranges, and you're not going to hit too many shots. And then even if you are hitting those shots, you're not going to do that much damage. So you really don't want to be doing any long range with this weapon. Overall, I had a very inconsistent time using this weapon because I just felt like in every scenario I was in, there was a better weapon for the job. And it just felt mediocre. And I'm not saying that this is the worst weapon in the game and it's just terrible and you should just never use it. Because it can do okay. You know, it's an okay weapon. I just think it needs a little bit of a buff or a tweak to kind of just bring it up onto the level of the other assault rifles. That's all I'm trying to say. And if you guys are struggling with this weapon like I have, I definitely suggest maybe playing it more like an LMG, staying back, getting those prone positions, those other positions, and being able to use that bipod. It's really going to help you land your shots, give you that increased accuracy, and definitely help you out. But yeah, those are just my 2 cents on the weapon. I don't know, let me know in the comments below what you guys think. Am I wrong? Is this weapon great? Or do you guys think it needs maybe a little bit of a tweak or buff? Definitely let me know and have a good one. See ya.